Okay, good afternoon to everyone. Hope you are well and good. So today I'm going to discuss about XML intermediate. Let's move to the next slide. So first part I'm going to discuss about XPath. Okay, what is XPath? XPath is a syntax used to define the parts of an XML document. It is used to selecting nodes from an XML document. XPath formats XML data as a tree structure values. XPath uses path expressions to navigate in XML documents. XPath is World Wide Web Consortium standard, and also XPath is a major element in XSLT. Move to the next. Look at this example. So the first line, this is we declare XML version 1.0 encoding UTF-8 bits. So this line we consider as, or we call as, document root node. The second line, second statement, that is the comment, we call the comment node. And look at the next, notebook code, and within the quotation mark we put the attribute node. This attribute node, and also we look at this one, we call this one is the element node. So this is element node, and then you look at the double quotation, we call this is attribute node. Next, look at this XPath tree XML example. So look at the first one, we call the document root. We use the slash, this is considered or defined as document root. Next is the comment node. This is simple example XML document. This is the comment, and next is the element node, and then next is we call attribute nodes. So look at attribute nodes, and the last one is the text node. Last one is the text node. Next, node terminology. Document root node. This is representing the root of an XML document. This node exists only at the top of the tree and may contain elements or comment. An element node represents an XML element and may contain element, text or comment. Attribute node represents an attribute of an element. And the text node represents the character data content of an element. And the comment node represent an XML comment. Next, look at this example here. So here is the report, then book. All these actually consider as the root node, then the attribute nodes and the text nodes. Okay, so if you want to represent the XML code using the XPath, so look at this example. The first one is we use the root document node using the slash. Second one, the name of the element node, report. Then also the book, also the element node, name of the element node. Then next is the attribute node. Here we have attribute node, the price, title, author. And the last one is we call the text node, the content of the each of the attribute node. Next, path expression. If we use the slash, that means selects the document root node, we call this is absolute path. If use the node name, that is means that selects all nodes with the specified node name, we call this is relative path. And if you use the slash, selects all descendant nodes of the current node that match the selection. If you use the expression dot, then it means that it selects the current node. If you use dot, that means selects the parent of the current node. If you use the alias sign, then this means that this selects attribute node. Next, path expression example. If we select the document root node, that means we can represent using the slash. Selects all the report nodes, in that case we can use the slash report node name. select all book element notes. In that case, we can use slash report slash note, or we can use double slash book. Select all title element notes. In that case, we can use slash report slash book slash title, or we can use double slash book slash title, or we can use double slash title. So these are the three actually representing selects all the title elements notes. Select all ID attribute note. In that case, we have to use slash slash alias ID. Select all first name element notes. In that case, we can use the path expression slash report book slash author slash first name, or we can use double slash author slash first name, or we can use double slash, then only we can use the first name. Next, if you want to use the brackets, basically brackets used for selects a particular matching child. So look at the path expression here, slash report slash book slash author within the bracket 1. That means selects elements of first author of every book, and output will be first author of every books. If you look at here, author Stephen Koch, author Dara Goldman, author David Tan. If you look, go back to the examples, the first author of every book, okay, the first author, look at here, this first book, the first author is Stephen Koch. Then next book, the first author Dara Goldman, and the last book, the third book, the first author David Tan. So if you go back to the output, you see Stephen Koch, Dara Goldman, and the David Tan. Okay, now if you use the path expression like slash report slash book slash author 1 slash text, the function name is text, then it will retrieve the name of first author of every book. First author of every book, if you look at here, is Stephen Koch, Dara Goldman, and the David Tan. So it will show you the first author of every book. Next, if you use the slash slash book slash author 2 within the bracket author 2, that is basically selects element of second author of every book. Second author of every book. If you look at here, the output is the first name of the second author is Mary, last name of the second author is Lee, then again the another author is Jordan Ong. So go back to the example, look, see who is the second author of every book. Second author, look at here, this is the first author, second author Mary Lee, and then another book we have at the end, the first author is Tan, the second author is Jordan Ong. So look at here, Jordan Ong, all right, Jordan Ong. Okay, now if you use the expression slash slash book 1 slash author, then within the bracket 2, that will basically retrieve second author of first book element. Second author of first book element. So here we'll get the output, the second author of first book element, we'll get the output Mary Lee. So if you go back, there is only one example here, Stephen Koch, and the first author of the second element is the Mary Lee. Okay, so second author of the first book is the Mary Lee. Next, path function. So we are using some path functions to do some of the actions. For example, if you use the note function, that will select all notes regardless of their type. That will select all notes regardless of their type. If you use the text function, select all text notes. If you use the comment function, select all comment notes. If you use the last function, return the number of notes in the last set. Return the number of notes in the last note set. In the note set. If you use the position function, it will return the position number of the current note in the note set. Return the position number of the current note in the note set. Next, last and the position function. Function last is bracket selects the last matching child node, and position function returns the position number of the current node in the node set. Look at the example here. Path expression slash report slash book slash author, then we use the function last. So what it will do, it will select element of last author of every book. Selects element of last author of every book. Last author of every book. So it will display the last author of every book. You see the last author, all the last author of every book, it will display here. Go back to the example and see last author. So here is the last author of this book. Last author of this second book is this Dara Goldman, and the last author of the third book is Jordan Ong. So you go back to the output again, you see. Okay, now if you use the path expression like slash report slash book slash author last function minus one, that means last author minus one, that means last minus one is previous one. Select elements of second last author of every book. Okay, last minus one, remember. So it will give you the output Mary, first name, and the last name Lee. This is the second last author of every book. Okay, then last one is the David Tan. Okay, look back here. So we have the first author, this is the last author, this is last author minus one. Last author minus one, it will be first name Mary and the last name Lee. We go back to the, this don't have, we have the second author or last author. We have the last author is here Jordan Ong minus one, so it will be David Tan. David Tan. So look at the output here. So you see Mary Lee and the David Tan, right? Okay, David Tan. Go back and see. So Mary Lee and David Tan, correct. So go back to the output again. Okay, correct. Okay, now if you use the expression path expression like slash slash title position equal to 2, or you use slash slash title 2, then it will give you, it will retrieve the second title of every book element. Second title of every book element. Remember, second title. So here we get the output C++ programming. Okay, look at the example here. Is it the second title of the each element or not? Second title we have the here we don't have one only. Here also one, database advanced is one. We have, yes, two. The first title is database basic and the second title is C++ programming. So it's supposed to give you the output C++ programming. Back to the output, yes, title C++ programming. Okay, next if you use the path expression like slash slash title 2 slash text, then it will retrieves the name of second title of every book. Retrieves the name of second title of every book. So it will give you the only the title. You see, C++ programming. If you go back, the second title of the every book, so this is only we have one second title C++. So it will give you the output C++ programming. Okay, I hope you understand how to use the last and the position function.